Well, if you're looking to expand your family, a pet could be just the ticket. Dr. Katy Nelson is back here with some beautiful little friends. Now this, I already forgot, Gigi?
Gigi. And Coco.
Coco.
Yes.
So cute.
I put blue and pink on so I could tell them apart, and I'm still having a hard time telling them apart.
They're both adoptable. That's the great thing.
They are. These two have lived together since they were little.
Oh, see ya. You want to jump?
And
this one's about to go.
Yeah. So we consider them what's called a bonded pair. So they're trying to adopt them out together. Because they've been together for so long, they don't want them to actually go to home separately because they think it would be too stressful on
How
them.
How old are they?
They're 5 and 6.
Mm-hmm. I'm trying
and
to find my friend.
She's back behind
I'm
you.
I'm chilling.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So they're 5 and 6. I don't know who's 5 or 6, but they're 5 and 6. Mm-hmm. And they both have been spayed and neutered. They are current on all of their vaccines. They're healthy little dogs. And so basically, like, you pay the adoption fee and you get, you know, a full-fledged dog that's already out of the whole puppyhood, but not yet old, so they're actually kind of almost the perfect age.
And what's their background? Why are they adoptable? What
The people who had them had to move and gave them up to the shelter. Not exactly sure why they couldn't go along, but they gave them up to the shelter.
Aww.
Together.
I'm sure they won't last too long in the shelter.
I sincerely hope not.
Doggies.
They're great little dogs. I mean, look at this guy. He's just chilling, watching his sister roaming around.
Yeah.
But they're both great little dogs, and they rode well in the car. They've been very well behaved here today. So.
And this one's just sniffing around.
Yeah, so I think they would be great little family dogs, especially, and you know, I do think that these would make good apartment dogs because they're not super high energy dogs. You can take them out for, you know, their little constitutionals a few
they're
times
smaller.
A day.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're small, and they don't shed. That's an amazing thing too. You know, little white dogs that don't shed are few and far between.
Yeah, I mean, you got black pants on. It's
yeah.
not showing up at all.
Yeah,
that's
no,
great.
Not at all. They're both nice little dogs, and they're purebred Bichon Frises. So you know, you're actually getting a purebred little dog.
Yeah, purebred. If I was to go for this like somewhere else, I mean, how much would these dogs
hundreds,
cost?
Hundreds each. Yeah.
Good deal.
Hundreds.
I want to talk about something else that's going on.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of pet food recalls.
Mm-hmm.
So wanted to ask you about that.
Yeah.
Why is there so many right now?
Well, there's a lot of recalls of everything right now. I mean, think about peanut butter recently and spinach
eggs,
and it's all because of salmonella. And that's the same reason why they've recalled so many of these foods is because of possible salmonella poisoning.
Mm-hmm.
Or salmonella contamination, I should say. And you know, I was actually just up in Cincinnati this past week for a Procter & Gamble thing, and they actually own the IAMS company, which is one of the more prominent companies that's had a recall. And
mm-hmm.
so I was asking them personally, you know, what's the deal here? And basically, most of these companies test their food. Every batch that goes out gets tested, gets cultured, make sure the vitamins, the minerals, and everything are okay, and make sure they don't grow anything like salmonella because they're handling a lot of ingredients that go into each of these diets.
And it's being mass produced.
Absolutely. And so what happened is, with IAMS specifically, their culture came back negative, the FDA's culture came back positive, and so therefore they shut everything down. They said, you know, we don't want to take a chance that
mm-hmm.
even though our culture was negative, we don't want to take a chance that there's potentially a bag of dog food out there with salmonella and could potentially make somebody's pet sick. So they just shut everything down. They recall everything and they just clean from top to bottom until they get it back to where they're confident making food in that factory again.
Is there one place where people can go if they have a pet or a cat to know if this food is recalled rather than just waiting and watching on the news and hoping to hear about it?
The AVMA, the American Veterinary Medical Association website, has a list of all of those recalled foods. So it's www.avma.org. And you can just go to their little search window, type in recall, and there's a list of all the recalled foods, and it actually goes back like 3 years.
Oh, so you can really check.
Yeah, I looked at it yesterday, and there's a ton of foods on there.
And what if you see something? You're going on the website, and you say, oh my gosh, I think I fed my pet that food.
Yeah.
What's the first step that you should do?
First step you should do is make sure you look at the UPC code, so that little barcode that gets scanned every time you buy a bag of food.
Mm-hmm.
They have that listed on the website, so particular UPC codes have been recalled.
So you look that up.
Mm-hmm. Particular dates have been recalled. And so you get that, write it down, you go grab your bag of food, which is why I always tell people, keep your bag. A lot of people will take their bag and dump it in a bin.
Or especially
and then throw
they have,
the bag
yeah,
away.
The containers, you know, right where they feed them.
Always keep your bag, or at least, you know exactly when you got it, where you got it, so you'll at least know what you have in your dog's bin. Go look at your bag, and you'll find your UPC code, you'll find your Best Buy date. If that matches, you know, then what? Then you pick up the phone and you call your veterinarian. That's really the best thing for you to do.
The other one's joining us now.
Yeah, hey, she came back. so if your pet food is on that list, first call you need to make is to your veterinarian. Talk with your veterinarian and say, you know, she's not showing any signs, but what do I need to do? Your veterinarian more than likely is going to tell you, okay, if she's not showing any signs, go ahead, stop feeding that food, and they're going to help you to pick something else to go to.
That was my next question. How do you make that transition if your dog's always been eating this or if your dog is picky? How do you know what to go to? Mostly talk to your vet?
Talk to your vet, but a lot of times these will be specific lots that are recalled. So it doesn't mean that every single bag on the shelf of your particular pet's food is going to be recalled, or every single line from the same brand is going to be recalled. So there are particular lines of the different foods that have been recalled, and mostly what that means is that they were produced in the same plant. You know, so if there's one that's comparable, your veterinarian will be able to help you pick out which one is comparable and talk you through the transition. You don't ever want to, you know, if you can avoid it, make an abrupt transition to a new diet. In this situation, if you've got a recalled food, you might have to, and so therefore your vet
just
might
just on the in-between.
Yeah, your vet might need to help you through it. You know, do you need to do a bland diet while you're transitioning or something like that?
Gotcha.
You know, that's something that your vet can really help you to make that transition, so your dog, even though they haven't gotten ill from the potentially contaminated food, they don't get ill because we're switching their diet
so abruptly.
Abrupt
change. Makes sense. Yeah. Well, once again, Gigi's over here on the left.
This
come back
Gigi.
To join us.
Absolutely.
And
she's
this
ready
is Coco.
For her close-up.
This, I want this one because she's just so chill.
You can take them both.
Oh, God, that would be trouble. I would have a zoo if it was up to me. All these dogs that you bring on here, I want to take them all home.
My husband threatens me, too. He's like, don't come home with a dog.
The number's up on, we have the number up on the screen, right, if you want to call it and, I almost said call and donate, call and adopt. I'm sure they'd accept donations
they
as well.
They absolutely
the Alexandria
accept donations,
Welfare
no
League. Dr. Katy Nelson, good to see you.
Good to see you.